Aurora Borealis, or we can call as Northern Light. The history of the Northern Light. The Italian astronomer Galileo Galilei, who coined the name of the Aurora Borealis in 1619. The name was after the Roman goddess of the dawn, Aurora, and the Greek god of the north of the Northern Light. It's in 300,000 years old. Cave Pantheon in France. But did you know how Aurora can happen? Yes, even though the Aurora are best seen at night, they are actually cursed by the sun. The sun sends us more than heat and light. It sends lots of the outer energy and the small particle our way. The protective magnetic field around the Earth shields us from the most of the energy and the particle. But the sun doesn't send the same amount of the energy all the time. There are constant streaming solar wind, and there are also solar storm. During one kind of the solar storm called the coronal mass ejection, the sun bursts out the huge of bubble of the electrified gas that can travel through the space at a high speed. When a solar storm comes toward us, some of the energy and the small particle can travel down the magnetic field lines at the north and the south pole into the Earth's atmosphere. The particle interact with the gases in our atmosphere, resulting in a beautiful display of the light in the sky. Oxygen gives off green and the red light. Nitrogen glows blue and purple. Did you know that Aurora just not happen on the Earth, but the other planet also have it? For example, there are sure do. Aurora are not just something that happen on the Earth. If a planet has an atmosphere and magnetic field, they are probably as aurora. We have seen amazing aurora on Jupiter and Saturn. Yes, the NASA Hubble Space Telescope took this picture of the aurora on the Jupiter using the ultraviolet UV light. And we also have the atmosphere of the red light are in the aurora of the south pole of the Saturn. Image are courtesy of the NASA, ESA, STSCI, and Sam Pollard.